And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery... mystery guest, for which I've asked my friends on the panel to put on their blindfolds. Jerry Lewis has got his on. Get that up where it belongs there, Lewis. Are all those blindfolds in place?
Ours are.
All right, fine. Then will the mystery challenger come in and sign in, please? As you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different form of questioning. You ask one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin it with Arlene Francis.
Are you associated in some way with show business?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis.
Are you a performer in the literal sense of the word?
Oui.
What is that, he said?
That's yes.
He's a little performer.
Yes.
Oui,
oui. Oh.
Miss Gilgallon?
Are you in the motion pictures?
Si.
Sir?
Si. I can't see, si. There was a strange... It seemed to me there was more applause after you signed in than when you walked out. So I wonder if it's possible that your chief fame is because of your reputation rather than visually. Is that correct?
Shouldn't so far.
I would say that it probably... Bennett, that our guest is known visually to great numbers of people, but at the same time, I would have to admit that he has a towering reputation, which rises even above the identification factor.
Thank you.
Miss Francis?
I'm in Pittsburgh. but the gentleman is a performer, you said, or he said, or wee-weed.
The gentleman does perform, yes.
He performs, but he performs mostly behind the scenes, am I led to understand?
What was this reading you just gave?
See.
Yes, I think that in balance we would have to say that behind the scenes is the principal area of operation.
Uh-huh.
Mr. Lewis?
But you do both behind the scenes as well as in front of the camera. Is that correct? Am I to believe?
Yeah. That's right.
That is true. Do I go again?
Yes, you go ahead, because you were merely re-establishing an already recorded fact.
Oh, thanks a heap. well, then, let me ask this. Do you work alone?
No.
One down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are you in any way associated with the production end of motion pictures?
Oui, ma'am, sir.
Mr. Cerf?
I think I know that voice from personal acquaintance. Are you beloved by millions and millions of children?
It's Gulliver.
The answer to that would have to be yes, Bennett.
Can I take a stab?
Yes, you can take a stab.
I think it's Walt Disney.
You're right.
To use the falsetto because that's the mouse.
That would have given it all away. Well, no, I actually, you did very well. That all those foreign languages and things. You know, Walt is a man of very great courage. Next Tuesday's, I guess it is next Tuesday, Saturday Evening Post is going to come out with an article written about Walt Disney by his daughter. And as far as I know, he's planned to stay in town and even in the country, aren't you?
Well, I think I should leave town. Conspiracy on the part of all the women in my family to give the lowdown.
I must say,
everybody had something to say in it, except there's one female that didn't say a word, and that's my dog.
Your dog didn't say anything. Well, they do say a man's best friend.
Could I ask you a question, Walt? When we had lunch together in Hollywood, you gave me a long list of all the wonderful additions you're going to put into Disneyland this year. Are they coming along?
Well, I completed those. I'm starting on next year.
the chairlift that's going over the whole, that inn? And the Palm Sawyer Island that you tell me about?
I made it. I made it in time for the summer season. Now I'm starting on my next year plans, which...
I'm sorry, Bennett.
I just wanted to say, give a plug to Disneyland. I think it's the most wonderful place for kids and adults I've ever visited in my life.
I just wanted to ask Walt a question. Walt, did you check with the government to see if they needed any money lately?
Put into this place. Oh, for heaven's sake.
Now, I would like, actually, it's no secret that Walt and I have worked basically in another network, but I'm more interested in what you think now about television after 2 or 3 years of exposure. And...
Well, it's wonderful. It's wonderful. You get to reach people in a sort of an immediate way with the pictures. You work for years, and then it's quite a while before you know how... what you're working on is going to come out, how it's going to be received. But with television, you know, well, in a very short time.
Do you find it's a burden, Walter, over the other working habits? Or
oh, no. No, I think I found it very stimulating.
Very stimulating.
For the whole staff, everybody, it's been a great stimulus for the whole organization.
That's fine. That's good, mm-hmm. You know, because that makes it sound like Mr. Walt Disney's going to stay in television, which is what I really wanted him to do. Walt, thanks very much.
It.
It's glad to have you with us, and nice of you to have been our guest. Will you say hello to Bennett?